beautiful.
We're almost a year of work of this entire community that has come together, creating puppets, creating costumes, performances, poetry, visual art. There have been workshops, not only at Two Bridges Neighborhood Council that have been running since March, building all the beautiful puppets and costumes at the workshops, but there have also been countless other workshops engaging different public schools, community centers, and other advocacy groups for the waterfront, the parks, and the gardens who've worked to create what we do here today. So I know it's tiring, it's a pilgrimage, it's a marathon, it requires endurance, but I think it's also part of the spirit of it that we need to push ourselves, because it's not an easy road we need to take with what we're up against in the biggest stakes possible for the future sustainability of humanity, all species, the planet, our water, our gardens, and everything that we do here locally means something globally. And I think there's a very different way of thinking about what we do here locally within the neighborhood, because the gardens sequester carbon. The gardens filter our air. The gardens are filtering pollution runoff from running into the rivers. They're also now leading in all of these climate resiliency solutions, from bioswales and water harvesting ponds and solar microgrids and permeable pathways, pollinator gardens and rain gardens, vertical farms. In the neighborhood, we have green roofs. We have bee farms on rooftops now. People want to put in community solar programs. There's sustainable community service agriculture programs where people can get local produce from farms, organic produce. All of these solutions, what's amazing is that they're being created by the community themselves. These are grassroots solutions that have yet to been properly acknowledged by the governor, by the mayor of the city. You will often see officials get up and speak about all the billions of dollars they're spending on sustainability initiatives out of the mayor's office of sustainability. Yet they still go and destroy gardens such as Elizabeth Street Garden and go after all these incredible spaces and initiatives and energy that's being handed to the community, to New York, to the world, free of cost, created by all the incredible energy of the people of this neighborhood. And so I think what today is about is finally acknowledging what the community has created, this incredible ecosystem of sustainability, an incredible model, not only for the neighborhood, New York, but for the world. See what they're making in the morning.